everybody. It's Fran. And I can't believe I'm going to have to do another one of these videos. I know some people don't like me doing these YouTube-based videos about what's going on YouTube, but you're going to want to hear this one. Because this isn't just about me, this one is about you and what you are going to be experiencing in the weeks and months and years ahead on YouTube, because those of us on the inside, the creators, I think yesterday or maybe 36 hours ago, got an email from YouTube telling us what's going to be happening in a few weeks. And the email said simply, you're receiving this email because we are making some changes to mid-roll ads that will impact your channel. These changes will make more videos eligible for mid-roll ads to increase your monetization potential. So, oh wow, this sounds great, huh? We can increase our monetization potential. Well, not so fast. You see, right now, if you make a video less than 10 minutes, you can't put in mid-roll ads. And what they're saying is that starting in late July, all videos longer than 8 minutes will be eligible for mid-roll ads. Well, so what? Well, the what of it is, as a part of this change, we will turn on mid-roll ads for all eligible videos. This means videos where you may have opted out of mid-roll ads will now be opted in, which means that if you're a channel like mine, where you have selected to not run any mid-roll ads, that is, ads that run in the middle of the video, which they don't run in my channel, if you selected that, they're saying that even though you selected that, come in July, ads are going to appear in the middle of your videos. and it says here, future uploads from monetizing channels will also have mid-roll ads turned on by default. All right. And this means that if you don't take advantage of their option right now to turn off this automatic thing, that the people who don't take action right now on this will have ads put in the middle of their videos, whether they like it or not. It goes on to say, if mid-roll ads are not a good fit for your videos, you can indicate this preference in YouTube Studio by July 27th, 2020. So I went in and did that. I had to follow a link to go to preferences, and in the mid, if there was a special new like pull down thing where you can edit it, they don't make it easy. You got to dig, and in there it pulls up this panel. It says mid roll ad preferences, and I selected that I will individually review and enable mid roll ads. I don't want it to be automatic. And when you make that choice, it pulls down this other like list where they want you to choose a reason, and I chose all three. It's because my content is not suitable for them, I'm worried about mid-roll ads decreasing my viewership, and I'm concerned with too many mid-roll ad breaks will be where they'll be placed. So I made all those choices click, so I turned off the default mid-roll ads. So what's the big deal, you say? What's the big deal? So on the creator page that we have, you know, on our side of YouTube, there is a differently worded panel similar to the email that we got that says kind of the same thing as part of the change. Mid-roll ads will be turned on for all eligible existing videos, including the videos where you've previously opted out. Okay. It says, turning on auto-roll ads saves creators extra work while helping increase the monetization potential for new and existing content. We use machine learning to automatically find the most natural breaks in your videos to increase monetization potential while balancing user experience. And it says on the creator page in the FAQs, how do automatically placed mid-roll ads work? It says automatically placed mid-roll ads aim to balance the viewer experience and creator monetization potential. YouTube's advanced machine learning technology looks over a large volume of videos and learns to detect the best places for your mid-rolls by evaluating factors like natural visual or audio breaks. User studies indicate that automatically placed mid-roll ads are 2 times less interruptive than manually placed mid-roll ads. So they're telling you that their Googlebot is better at editing than the human being. It says, aren't mid-roll ads annoying for viewers? While some viewers might find mid-roll ads annoying or interruptive, We take care of predicting the best ad placement for minimal interruption to viewer experience. And this is the key here, this last sentence. We aim to balance the needs of viewers, advertisers, and creators on our platform. And this is what it comes down to. You're going to be experiencing so many more ads on YouTube, unless of course you have ad blocker running on your browser like pretty much anyone on YouTube would. But because people run ad blockers on the browsers, and because, and I say this, YouTube has done this to themselves, okay? They're under pressure from advertisers to run more ads. But over the past years, YouTube has imposed restrictions on ads on every channel. So they've made it harder and harder to monetize content because of all these rules with the way advertisers want to dictate what kind of videos that they'll be advertised on. Unless you're making the most bland and most milquetoast, most benign and boring content on YouTube, then chances are you're already being restricted as to what kind of advertising can be on your video, or you may not be able to have any advertising on your video at all because there's you know, 3 seconds of a song that's in the background of your video, or because you said a word you weren't supposed to, or the Googlebot takes what you're saying out of context and thinks that you're talking about something controversial when you're not, or maybe you're making a controversial video and advertisers won't advertise on that. Whatever the reason, YouTube has created this adpocalypse by restricting advertising over the years, and now advertisers are like, we're not getting the revenue because you're not running our ads. Well, we're not running your ads because you say you don't want your ads running on these videos, so yada yada. So their solution is, we're just going to run an ass load of ads on any video that's over 8 minutes long by default. And what it comes down to is this. If you're still watching this, you're still probably saying, well, what is the big deal? Ads, so what? I got ad blocker, okay. In 2018, I made a video called WTF YouTube, and you might have even seen it. I made that video back then because at that time, in September 2018, my channel was not monetized. I was determined not to monetize my channel, and for years I said, my channel will never be monetized, and I really meant it. But when I made that video, it was because I had done the analysis of my analytics for the previous 6, 8, 10 months and saw that all of a sudden YouTube had just stopped sharing my channel, all my content. My videos were not being circulated outside of my subscribership, and YouTube had basically just shelved my channel, and my channel wasn't growing. And even though I was making really good content and making steady content throughout that entire year, my views were very low, and no one outside of my subscribership was seeing any of my videos. And even though YouTube said at the time that you do not have to be monetized to get a video shared and everything, they kept it very much close to the chest, so to speak. It was clear from my analysis that I was being punished for not having monetization turned on. So as a result of the analysis from that video, I turned on monetization, and wow, what happened? My channel all of a sudden got shared and has been shared steadily ever since. And ever since I monetized my channel, although, and this is important, I have minimally monetized my channel because not all of my videos are monetized, and the ones that are only have skippable ads at the beginning. That's it. I don't put them at the end. I don't put them in the middle. Skippable ads in the beginning. So anyone who watches any of my videos, if it does have an ad in it, you can skip it, blah, right? And that's the way I set it up. But even just doing that, YouTube was sharing my videos and my channel grew. I hit 100,000 subscribers and all that stuff, all that happened because I turned monetization on. So with these new rules that are coming out in July, right, the implication of this is that channels that opt out of mid-roll ads, like I have done, very good chance that these channels will be shelved. Which means that because I've selected that I don't want mid-roll ads to be automatically put in the middle of my videos by the Googlebot, that there's a very good chance that in the weeks and months to come, that I'll see my channel go like that. And if it turns out that over the months, as I continue to make videos, if my videos aren't being shared outside my subscribership, anymore, then I will know what it is, that it's this thing. And I am almost certain that there's going to be fallout from this for people who opt out, you know, unless you already got like 2 million subscribers and, you know, and have a huge Facebook presence and you've got a really high, you know, Twitter, you know, follower count and all that. So if you got all the social media pegged, unless you're in that category, you're probably going to find that there's a consequence to opting out of the mid-roll Adpocalypse. And the postscript to this one has nothing to do with this, but I didn't want to make a whole video on it because it was such a small thing. But interestingly enough, I also found out that over the past week or so, a change has been made in the YouTube platform where copyright flagging is now happening on offline videos, because I had mentioned in previous videos that my Voyager record video that I made years ago was getting slammed so much with copyright claims that, and I re-edited it a couple times and took out audio, and every time I put it back up, it would get slammed again by some other lawyer and some other company for some other claim on that thing. And so it was getting slammed so much that I took it down. Now, I didn't erase the video. I simply took it offline and made it private, right? So basically, it's unviewable. But you know, a few days ago, I got a copyright claim on that video, that offline video that hadn't been viewed in like a year and a half or something, got slammed with another copyright violation. So it turns out that now, even if you have a private video that isn't viewable by anyone but yourself, it's still subject to copyright claims and flagging. So, okay, well, that's it. I mean, that's it. And I don't care if people skip my ads. That's why they're skippable. You know, if you run ad block on your browser, you know, you're not going to be affected by this at all. But I don't know what this means. If this is a good omen or a bad omen, does this mean that YouTube is just becoming more successful, or does this mean that YouTube is getting desperate? Could be either one, or maybe both. But anyway, this video is long enough, and there's gonna be no mid-roll ads because I've opted out of it. If you see a mid-roll ad on any of my videos, let me know, because they're not supposed to be running. But that's it for the 2020 YouTube Adpocalypse, coming soon to a browser near you. All right, that's it for this one. I really didn't intend on making another rant video. This one just, you know, I had to make it because of the, today's when it, you know, announcement was made. So I just wanted you to know, didn't plan on having this one like right now. I had another one I was gonna do, but so be it. There you go. Thanks for tuning in and sticking it out, and thanks for, you know, watching my channel. I hope that I get circulated even without the mid-roll ads being autobotted into my long videos, because my videos are always more than 8 minutes. And you know, I want to thank all the patrons on the Patreon that support the channel, keep the lights on. These very lights right here are being kept on by the patrons on Patreon. It's really the only reason I'm able to do this, even making a stupid video like this one, yet another rant about YouTube. It just doesn't stop. You know, they just won't leave it alone. It's always gotta be like messing with the pudding. So what are you gonna do? All right. That's it. I'm Fran. I'll see you back here. Well, probably over there at the bench real soon. Berserk in my lab, it's where I work.
for watching. Fran laugh. It's what I'm doing. Working at the bench again.